Hello friends, hope you had a great Thanksgiving weekend. Here we are with Daily Toast on December 1st. It is the last month of the year and the last month of Daily Toast. So in this month, we gotta fit in all the games that we haven't had time for before. So yeah, let's just squish them all in there. Let's start with a good one this week, so Toast. And today we are toasting one of my favorite remakes of all time, Super Mario 64 DS. And honestly, this game is, in my opinion, nothing short of spectacular, right? Now, the original Super Mario 64, when it came out, it was mind-blowing. It was just insane how different it is from any other video game that had ever been made, right? But, you know, the younger kids that weren't around in those days, who don't remember a time before Super Mario 64, the game, I've heard kids say, oh man, Super Mario 64 sucks, yeah, stuff like that, and has, you know, you just go, ignorant child, you know, stuff. I'm just kidding, but anyway, yeah, Super Mario 64 was amazing, but I think it did have flaws. It had some major flaws, controls, angles, graphics, and Nintendo saw that. And they decided, hey, you know, we're going to show off what our new system can do, the DS, and we're going to re-release Super Mario 64. We'll show that this handheld can do a full 3D 64 game, but we're going to make it even better. And that's what they did, right? They improved the graphics the entire game. It's all, everything's still there, but it all looks better. Every environment looks better. Every character looks better. I mean, like, Bowser in the original, you know, looks all shapy and everything, and now he looks like he does in modern games, you know. So, sure, he's still a little shapy. It is the DS. All the characters are a little shapy, but they do look much, much better than they did in the original Super Mario 64, right? So, what's nifty? You know how in the original game, you get to the end of the game, you get all 120 stars, you go up on top of the roof of the castle, and there's Yoshi hanging out. Well, they kind of play with that in this one, in that, you know, the original story, Peach invites Mario over for some cake. This one, she says, bring your friends, so he brings Luigi and Wario, for some reason, to go get cake, and the three of them go into the castle, the three of them get captured, right? Lakitu, the cameraman, figures out, well, great, now we don't have a story. So he goes to Yoshi, who's sleeping on top of the castle, just waiting there, and says, hey, wake up, your friends have been kidnapped. So Yoshi has to go rescue them, right? So these first few levels, you have to do as Yoshi. And yes, sometimes Mario is required, so you have to find a Goomba wearing a Mario hat. Yoshi puts on the Mario hat, and that transforms him into Mario. We can see that throughout the game also. If you find a Goomba wearing a Wario hat or a Luigi hat, Yoshi can transform into those characters by putting on their hats. That's pretty nifty. That's a really, really interesting power-up that I'm surprised we haven't seen more of, right? Let's see. So, yes, you play those first few levels as Yoshi, right? And from there on, the game is just awesome because here's the game, Super Mario 64, same old game, but they enhanced it because now you're Yoshi. You can do the flutter jump. You can eat enemies. You can throw eggs. All Yoshi's abilities are now here in Super Mario 64. You rescue Mario. You rescue Luigi. Luigi does his kicky jumps like he does in Mario 2, right? He's faster. He jumps higher. It's all Luigi's abilities, but in Super Mario 64. You get Wario. He's a bit slower, but he's got his strength, right? That's Wario's strong point. Strong. That toast in this game, right? That's Wario in this game. So that's cool that we have Wario, we have Luigi, we have Yoshi, all in Super Mario 64, and Wario can do backflips. They can all do backflips. This game is really cool because of the characters, but then they also add a lot of other enhancements. A lot more stars. The original had 120 stars. This one has 150 stars. Some of which you can only get with Luigi. Some you can only get with Yoshi. Some you can only get with Wario. So that's really, really cool. This game is also, I feel like, there's less cheap deaths. Less, you know, like you're walking on a narrow edge and you fall off and then 64 version just because you don't have good enough control of your character. This one, I don't feel like this problem. Yes, a lot of people complain that with a D-pad, you can't control your character well enough in a 3D environment. I completely disagree. I find it so much easier to control my character with the D-pad than with the original N64 joystick. I've never tried this one on a 3DS with the circle pad, so maybe that will help people complain about the D-pad. So yeah, toast. Anyway, Super Mario 64 DS. It is a game that I think you just can't go without. Oh, and the Goomba King from Paper Mario is in this game. The King Goomba. So that's really cool that they would include him in this, of all people. Right? So now we got a Bob-omb King and a Goomba King in this game. And that's not all. They also added all these tons of fun mini games that you get to play with your stylus. There's casino games and whack-a-mole games and games where you draw little lines to make trampolines for Mario's. And oh, my favorite is the Bob-omb sorting game. Grab the Bob-omb, put them in place. Grab the Bob-omb, put them, you know, you black Bob-ombs, red Bob-omb. Oh, it's so fun. It's so many good mini games. So that's awesome. So yeah, better controls, better graphics, tons of extra mini games. Seriously, if you've never played Super Mario 64 DS, this is a must-have for any handheld game player. So yes, thank you so much for watching. Tune in tomorrow Tuesday for another Daily Toast.